These dogs will never be quiet. It's like they wait until I click record and then. Hey, welcome back. I hope you are having an amazing 2019 so far. I have just been getting back to the grind and back to the routine after going to Vegas. I actually posted about this set while I was in Las Vegas, and I picked it up at the Sephora there and did the video of the swatches in my hotel room. But now I've had a week to really use all of the products, more than a week now. I bought another set to give away, so stay tuned, all the giveaway information will be towards the end of the video. If you wanna see swatches of this set, I have a separate video and I'll link that right here and in the description, and you can watch my live swatches that I did. I'll start with the two lip balms. There was a Sugar Fresh Advanced Therapy lip balm and an Incredible Jelly Shot, they call it a lip quencher. Okay, I would say the sugar lip balm, the sugar fresh sugar lip balm is cool because, you know, the packaging, it's like you twist it and it's just, it's luxurious. It feels nice and it feels luxurious, but it's a deluxe size, which is fine. But it actually works. I don't think as a lip balm, it's anything life-changing. Maybe the tinted ones are better, but like I've tried it before and I like the product, but I definitely wouldn't go and buy it on its own. I think if you want the set for other reasons and you like the fact that this is in here, then it's a good deal, but otherwise, overall though, I do really like this product. I just don't think that, I don't know, it's lip balm. Like I can get, my favorite lip balm of all time is Aquaphor Lip Advanced Lip Therapy, the little mini Aquaphor tube, and it is $3.99 or $4.99 at Target, and that just does the trick. That's my favorite lip balm of all time. I just like don't find it necessary, but I do think this is still a good lip balm. So, I mean, I like it, but it's just not, it's not life-changing, it's not a necessity, you don't need it. This, I'm not really that impressed with. If you look at the product itself, it's just really like, it's a light, very thin product. I don't even think it does anything. Like, I just see a little, you see it like you barely see any shine, but you see like a little bit of shine. This truly, I don't feel like does much, but like make my lips look a little bit shiny for a little while, but I don't think it deeply hydrates. I think that the sugar lip balm, the fresh sugar lip balm, hydrates a lot better than this, but this one's full size. I mean, I've just kind of been throwing it on here and there, like, it just, meh. I mean, the fact that they included lip balms in this, to me, is kind of weird. I think it would be cool if they had done, like, a whole lip balm set, like, give me some lip hydration or something, and it was all, like, different kinds of lip balms, maybe tinted ones, regular ones. I think that's a good way to, like, you know, do a specific set and then maybe include like a different set that's just glosses for people who like glosses and want to experiment. I think they need to diversify the sets a little bit more and give more options for people with darker skin tones for sure. The next thing I tried, this I really, really loved and I still like it a lot. It's the YSL Volupté Liquid Balm in shade number 12, Chase Me Nude. And I actually really like this product. I don't think as like a liquid balm, it does feel like a liquid balm, but I don't actually think it hydrates much. I think it's so thin and so watery, it's very, very thin and watery, that to really get any actual true color out of it, I have to put on a little bit of lip liner underneath, but I find that once it goes away, I still get that, the color kind of stains my lips, so it's still nice, and I still like it. Really like this product just because it smells great, the color is beautiful, and it's comfortable to wear. I don't think the hydrating power is anything special. Like, I find my lips like shrivel up after a while of wearing this, and it just kind of doesn't hydrate. Like, it dries my lips out after a while. So maybe it's just kind of like a top coat of hydration. I don't know. I mean, I really don't need fancy lip balms. Like, if I wanted this color, I would just use a lip liner in this color and put Aquaphor over it and call it a freaking day. But if you want to get fancy, I like it. I like it. I'm not saying I don't like it. It's probably still my favorite product out of all of this set just because it's a very easy wearable color. It's right up my alley and it's like just a easy product to throw on. The next thing I had a major problem with when I tried on was the Tarte H2O gloss in the color Sundress. I have this on right now, and I actually find that like instead of putting it on my lips by itself and freaking out like I did last time, I use it over the L'Oreal number 800 Fairest Nude. This is the color Riche lipstick. It's just a nude lipstick that I love. It was in my top 5 nude lipsticks video. If you haven't seen that, you can check it out. But it doesn't have to be that lipstick, but I think putting this on top of just any kind of nude lipstick or maybe some lip liner and just kind of in the middle, it's nice. I really, really like it in this sense, in this situation, I think I will use this a lot and I actually like it. So I'm definitely more impressed with this now than I was before, but for my skin tone, this is not the color to just throw on your lips and get out the door. This was from one of the last sets. It's the same product, but it's in the color Hang 10. So you can see, I guess you can see how much darker that is, right? That is the older one and this is the one in this set, but I really like the older one. It's something, this is a color I can like throw on and just leave. But for me, this is something I have to put over a nude lipstick, but I really, really like it. So I am definitely, it's grown on me. It's grown on me. The next one is the Anastasia Beverly Hills lip gloss in the color Venus. They call it like a glittery gold. To me, it's more of a peachy gold glitter. I like this. I did wear this to work one day and then I wore it out a few days, just like out and about during my day. Oh my God, I'm so sorry if you can still hear these dogs barking because they will not stop. And I can't adhere to their schedule. I gotta keep filming. They're really, really driving me crazy. But so I did wear this a few days in a row and just kind of played with it a little. I don't think it's something I would put all over my lips. I kind of also put it a little bit in the center and then a little bit like near the cupid's bow. But I didn't find that once it came off, I don't think the glitter stayed or like went everywhere. That's something I don't like about glittery glosses. But overall, I'm not a huge glitter gloss person and I still liked it. It wouldn't be like an ideal lip gloss. Like it's not something I would reach for all the time, but YOLO, right? And this is also one of the full size products in this set. It's really comfortable. I didn't think that it like went outside my lip lines much. Do I even want to talk about this? It was kind of a traumatic experience for me, not gonna lie. This thing burned the crap out of my lips and I knew it was gonna burn, but I don't think I used this specific product before, so I didn't know it was gonna burn this much. This is the Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme. And I think before I had only tried on and complained about either the Buxom glosses or the Marc Jacobs glosses. And then the only Too Faced lip injection I had tried is the regular one, not the extreme one. This one says Turbo Power Supreme Plumping Gloss. That sounds like a freaking car engine. Like, I don't want turbo power irritation on my freaking lips. I don't like this product. And if you watch my video, you saw my first reaction to the swatch. I started freaking out. It really irritated my lips. I think for me, I did a Lip Care 101 video and I'm very big on the fact that like, lips are still part of your face, like part of your skin of your face. And we treat our lips like shit sometimes, you know? We wear drying matte lipsticks and super fragrant, super irritating products. So I am not a fan of super irritating products. I don't use any fragrance on my face. So using fragrance lip products on my lips, which I do, is already kind of like as far as I'll go. But just the fact that I'm burning the crap out of my lips to make them swell up and be irritated and red, just, I'm not down for that. I'm not down. And if you are, you will like this. But I do not like this. I just really don't like this product. I might get adventurous and try it maybe again, but I think most likely I'm just gonna give it to one of my friends who I know loves plumping lip products. I just cannot deal with the irritation. I can't deal with the fact that it burns and it makes me uncomfortable and it's not good for my skin. Just in terms of two of the full size products in the set, I'm not really like stoked about either of them. I like this better for sure. This one's kind of meh. I don't really think it does anything. I'm surprised they even like have these kind of products here. I thought this whole like flower lipstick thing was old news, but you know, meh. I think my whole overall feel about this set is just meh. It is still a nice set of products. I think that if you are really into like different kinds of lip balms, that's nice because then you can try, you know, unless you drop them. You can try three different kinds of lip balms and then you can try two different glosses. But personally, to be completely transparent, like I only bought this set because I love making these videos. Doing the Sephora favorites lip videos are my favorite videos to make. So I was like, I don't care if I use it or not, I have to buy it. So just because I bought it doesn't mean you need it. But if you do want it and you don't want to pay for it, you can enter my giveaway. However, I just think my overall thought about this set is I do like it after using it for quite a while, but it's just, I still don't think it's a necessary set. Like I think a lot of the Give Me Some Nude Lip or Give Me Some Bold Lip sets are a lot more fun than this one. This one I find to just be a little bit whatever. Like it just is weird. It's a weird combo of stuff. That is the whole entire set. So if you want to enter my giveaway, I have a link to enter below. Just make sure you're subscribed to my channel and check that link out. It'll tell you exactly what to do. That is it. That's my thoughts on this set. I think it's kind of a weird combo of products, but I do think it's still fun to play with. I just don't think it's a necessary purchase for most people. Let me know though in the comments if you're gonna be buying it or not, and definitely enter my giveaway. Maybe you can get it and not have to buy it. I hope everyone's year is going very, very well so far, and I hope all your dreams and goals come true in 2019. We're gonna be hustling together. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video.